We are going to discuss is permanent and temporary magnets. So what are permanent and temporary magnets and how we can differentiate them? So permanent magnets and temporary magnets can be differentiated on their basis of nature and strength. So permanent magnets will not lose its magnetism easily. And temporary magnets behave as a magnet under certain conditions and loses its magnetism under the conditions when not fulfilled. Then the second point is given, permanent magnets are prepared from steel and special alloys of iron, and temporary magnets are prepared from soft iron. So what is the term here, soft iron? Soft iron means the iron piece which loses its magnetism easily. Next, third point, permanent magnet can be used to magnetize an iron piece. And the third point here, temporary magnets cannot be used to magnetize an iron piece. Related to this third point, permanent magnets can be used to magnetize an iron piece. So let's see how to make magnets. We can make magnets by two methods, that is single touch method of magnetization and double touch method of magnetization. So let's see what is happening in single touch magnetization. As you can see here in the activity number 9, to show single touch method of magnetization. So for single touch method of magnetization, we require here a steel or an iron piece, a strip of iron. Here I have taken as an example a steel scale. So we'll mark here point number A and point number B. Now what we will do, we will take a magnet and we will keep at the end point A. So I have kept here and we have to drag it to the position B like this. We have to drag it and then we will lift the magnet and will bring again to position A and drag towards B and then lift and then bring it to A position. So this is the procedure which we have to follow for magnetization. So this dragging is done at least 40 to 50 times and we don't have to drag reverse. That means B to A we don't have to do. Instead we have to drag from A position to B and then lift again, then come to A position and then drag towards B position. So this you will do 40 to 50 times. And after some time, we will see that the steel scale which we have taken, that will behave as a magnet for a short duration. Next one is double touch magnetization. So in double touch magnetization, as we are using the same steel scale and we have to take two magnets. And then, like here in the figure, it's shown. Two magnets taken on a steel rod and kept in the middle, and we have to keep in mind that the two magnets are kept opposite poles. Like one magnet is having south pole and the other magnet is having north pole and they are dragged in opposite direction. Like I'll show you. So here I have taken two clips that can be assumed as a magnet. So we have to keep it in the middle and then we have to drag in opposite direction. Then we will lift the magnet and bring it into the center and then we will drag like this in opposite direction. Then we will lift the magnet and then come to middle and then drag. So this is the way to make the magnet by double touch method. This method is also used, or when we are doing this process, we have to repeat the dragging process at least 40 to 50 times. Then only the steel rod which we have taken, that will start behaving like a magnet, but a temporary magnet. Next topic we are going to discuss is electromagnet. Now in electromagnet, the magnet made by using an electric current. So now here for the electromagnet we are using a magnet, and soft iron is used, and with that coiling of the wire is done. As you can see in the figure, this is a soft iron bar taken, and on this electric wire is wrapped in a circular positions, in the circular way. So now what will happen, the end of the wire, that means two end of the wire, they are connected with the battery. So now as we connect the two end of the electric wire to the battery, this iron bar will start behaving like a magnet. So this is the way to prepare electromagnet. So as the term is electromagnet, preparing magnet with the help of electric current. So if the current in the coil is turned off, the soft iron bar will lose its magnetism immediately. So the electromagnet is a temporary magnet. So in this activity it is explained the same. Here is taken an iron bar or soft iron bar and is wounded by the electric wire, and two ends of the wire is connected to a battery. So when we bring this bar magnet, or we can say a soft iron connected with a battery, that means this is now electromagnet. When we bring this electromagnet near the pins, so they will be attracted, as though this is not a magnet, but it will behave like a magnet. This is not a permanent but a temporary magnet.